to the Mount Olive AME Zion Church, where we are advancing the kingdom of God by making disciples. Thank you for joining us. We pray that you will be encouraged by the word that is shared on today. At the end of the message, we will provide you more information on how to connect with our church. Be blessed.
The announcements.
The Voices of Mount Olive prepared a Christmas celebration that will be uploaded to the Mount Olive YouTube channel today, December 19th at 3 p.m. Please join us as we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ.
Greetings, Mount Olive Church family. Here we are again, closing out another year and looking forward to a new one. 2021 was an interesting year. As you are celebrating this holiday season of giving, please keep your pastor, Reverend Hobson, and his family in mind this Christmas. Although we are still unable to be physically present in church to worship together, Reverend Hobson worked hard at getting out the message to us and to keep us engaged virtually. So if you desire to present your pastor a gift, you can send it to the church by mail, or you can drop it off at the church by leaving it in this church mailbox. I will make sure that he receives his gifts. Thank you, God bless you, and Merry Christmas to you. Your Preacher Stewart.
December 27th to the 30th, Annual Christian Education Winter Meeting, Chicago, Illinois. Truthville 2021, Life After Exile, Psalms 126, verse 1. Due to safety concerns, the meeting will be held virtually. More information forthcoming.
Hello, family and friends. Thank you for joining with us. This is Pastor Hobson. I have a few announcements that I want to make. First of all, on Friday, December the 31st, we are getting together for in-person worship for a watch night service, Mount Olive AME Zion Church, Zion Baptist Church, and Grace Baptist Church. We're getting together at Zion Baptist at 6 p.m. on Friday, December the 31st at 6 p.m. The three churches we normally get together, but for the past couple of years, we have been unable to do so. And so we are excited about this opportunity. I'll be the guest preacher, and Zion Baptist, they're going to be singing and blessing us. And so we ask that you come on out. Protocols will be in place to provide safe space. And so let's come out and celebrate the goodness of God. Also, on the first Sunday of 2022, Mount Olive AME Zion, we're going to be getting together to celebrate communion and worship God in person at the Now, at 11 a.m. So we're excited about this. We know that we are not in the building. We have some repairs and things that are going on. But on this first Sunday of the new year, we did not want to allow this time to pass us by without us getting together with protocols in place to provide safe space that we might worship and praise the God of our salvation. And on Sunday, January the 9th, we're going to be celebrating our annual Men's Day. The theme is serving by the Spirit to the glory of God. 2 Peter chapter 4, verses 10 through 11 talks about the fact that God has given us a variety of spiritual gifts, not to serve ourselves, but to serve one another. And we do this to the glory of God. God will be glorified. And so men and women alike, boys and girls, young and old, come on, join with us on Sunday, January the 9th, to celebrate our annual Men's Day. Look forward to seeing you there.
News first, fellowship and prayer with the pastor. Tuesday at 1 p.m. via conference call. Prayer every Wednesday at 11:30 a.m. Bible study every Wednesday at 12 noon and 6 p.m.
via Zoom and conference call. Sunday school every Sunday at 9:30 a.m. via conference call. Class leaders meeting is every second and fourth Monday at 1 p.m. Please govern yourselves accordingly and have a blessed week.
Thank you. to you all. My name is Reverend Albertus Bacote III, and I am an associate minister at Mount Olive AME Zion Church. We'll be going to the Word of God from the book of St. Luke, chapter 2, verses 8 through 14. In the Word of God in Luke, chapter 2, verses 18, goes like this. And there were shepherds living out in the fields, nearby keeping watch over the flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Do not be afraid. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God, saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those of whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." Amen. Let us pray. Dear Lord, I want to thank you for this opportunity to bring the word. Lord, I ask that those under the sound of my voice hear what the Lord has to say, not Reverend Albertus Bacote III. Minister to their hearts, Lord God. Allow them to know your peace. In Jesus' name, amen. The gift of peace. The gift of peace. Reverend Hobson has been preaching an Advent sermon series that has covered hope, faith, and joy. Today, we are going to discuss peace. For those who are first-time listeners of this Advent sermon series, Advent is derived from a Latin word, adventus, meaning coming, with a translation of the Greek word parousia. You might ask, coming of what? This is where it really gets good. It is the coming of the Son of God, Jesus the Christ. Now, the first Advent is the birth of Jesus, and the second Advent is the expectation of Jesus' return. That's good news that should excite someone besides me. Now, a lot of preparation goes into this time of Advent that leads to the celebration of the birth of the Savior of the world on Christmas Day. Now, besides church services that commemorate Advent, there is also the hustle and the bustle of putting up the Christmas tree. I remember growing up with my mother, and I remember her having me and my siblings go and get the cram Christmas tree from the last year that was in the box, placed all the way in the back of the closet, along with the lights, along with the tinsel, and along with you better not break any of my Christmas bulbs. Now, in addition to Christmas decorations, the Christmas list has to be made. Then the gifts have to be purchased, and as well as wrapping paper for the gifts. I've heard many people say what they love most about Christmas season is the giving. Many gifts will be given and many gifts will be received. Giving is so much easier when the person giving the gift knows exactly what you want. This is what I call the ultimate gift-giving experience. This is the last week for many to get their last-minute gifts for family, for their friends, and for coworkers. Now, I wonder how many people would like a gift called peace to be given to them on Christmas Day. Now, during the Advent and Christmas season, you'll see the phrase, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace, goodwill toward men. And you'll see this phrase on Christmas decorations, Christmas cards, or billboards. You'll also more than likely hear it on the radio and different songs. As you already know, this phrase originated in the Bible. The setting was shepherds in the fields watching over the flocks at night. Surprisingly, they were able to experience a visitation from an angel of the Lord, along with a heavenly host of angels praising God, saying glory to God in the highest, on earth peace, goodwill toward men. Now, this declaration from the angel of the Lord was extremely good news. Good news, good news. Because the prophet Isaiah had spoke about this coming Savior long, long time ago, centuries before these shepherds were even born. This time has finally come for the Savior of the world to appear. Isaiah 9:6 tells us, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. When God makes a promise, he keeps his promises. And we have evidence of that based on the angelic host praising God, declaring glory to God in the highest and on earth peace, goodwill toward men, and the fact that God sent Jesus to be the Savior of the world. Today, when people hear or see that phrase, it usually brings up the idea of the world being absent of war or conflict, and people being genuinely interested in the goodwill of their neighbor. Now, this idea sounds and feels good, but it really isn't what the angels were trying to communicate. Glory to God in the highest and on earth peace, goodwill toward men, comes directly out of the King James Version of the Bible, which was written in 1611. The Greek manuscripts the scholars had on hand at the time was what was used when translating those Greek manuscripts into English. After translation was completed, the outcome of Luke chapter 2, verse 14 read, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. Since 1611, research has played a part in understanding the Bible much better. For example, there has been a better understanding of the development of the Greek text over time. There has also been a better understanding of the Bible due to the discovery and coordination of more texts. There has also been a better understanding of the Bible due to the discovery of the Dead Sea Scrolls, which were discovered in 1947. Also, due to the extensive number of early manuscripts available today, along with computer technology that allows very accurate comparisons of the text and the hard work of scholars, the modern Greek text of the New Testament has been translated into English and is very, very accurate. Today, a more accurate reading of Luke chapter 2:14 and updated versions of the Bible will read different from the 1611 King James Version. For example, Luke chapter 2:14 reads from the NIV, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests." The NLT and the ESV versions read, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and peace on earth to those whom God is well pleased." In a nutshell, the angels were wishing peace to those God favors or to those he is pleased with. The question might come up, why is peace only offered to those who God favors or he is pleased with? Well, we first had to back up and look at what the angel of the Lord declared. He declared that he brings them good news of a great joy that will be for not just a certain group of people, but for all people. The good news was that day in Bethlehem, a Savior was born. Now that truly is good news, because the Savior is for all people. Now, someone might ask, if the good news is for all people, then why did the angel only offer peace to those God favors or is pleased with? That's a good question. The reason is all people will not want the gift of peace that Jesus Christ can give them. You mean to tell me that there are going to be some folks that don't want the peace that Jesus, who is the Savior of the world, can give them? That is correct, preacher. The next question that might come up is, why in the world would people not want the gift of peace from Jesus? Well, the answer is because some people don't want to live a life that God is pleased with, or they don't want to live a life that God favors. The good news is Jesus the Christ is the Savior for all people. The question might come up, why are people not at peace with God? The answer is found in three scriptures. Romans chapter 3, verse 23 tells us, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." Romans chapter 6, 23, "For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus." And Romans chapter 5, 8, verse 8 tells us, "God demonstrates his own love for us in this: while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us." So until we put our faith in believing that Jesus is the only one that can bring peace between God and ourselves, we will not have peace with God. John chapter 1, verse 12 tells us, "To all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave them the right to become children of God." And 1 John chapter 3, verse 2 tells us, "Dear friends, now we are children of God, and what we will be has not yet been made known. But we know that when Christ appears, we shall be like him. Praise the Lord. For we shall see him as he is. Jesus not only gives us peace with God, since he is the Prince of Peace, which is found in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, but he also gives us peace for human relationships. In Romans chapter 12, verse 18, the Word of God tells us, do all that you can do to live in peace with everyone. In Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14 says, be at peace with all men. Live a holy life. No one will see the Lord without having that kind of life. Jesus, the Prince of Peace, doesn't just stop there. He also gives us peace with ourselves. The Word of God tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, if anyone be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. In Philippians chapter 1, verse 6, tells us, I am sure of this, that he who began a good work in you will bring it to completion at the day of Jesus Christ. Every Christmas, people will see and hear, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men. And interpret that phrase as the angels declaring peace on earth. And there is really nothing wrong about someone, whether it is an angel or whether it is a human, wishing there be peace on earth. There was a song that came out some time ago sung by Dionne Warwick. And the title was, What the World Needs Now is Love, Sweet Love. That statement still holds true today, but we could also substitute love and replace it with peace, declaring what the world needs now is peace, sweet peace. In 1981, the United Nations declared September the 21st to be Peace Day. Peace Day is a day to commemorate and strengthen the ideals of peace through observing 24 hours of nonviolence and ceasefire, both from within and among all nations of people. In 2021, peace was celebrated by standing up against acts of hate online and offline, and by spreading compassion, kindness, and hope in the face of a pandemic and as we recover. Now, can you imagine if that one day of peace lasted for 7 days? Or if that one day of peace continued and lasted for 30 days? What a difference it will make on earth. If people who were at odds with one another decided to make peace with one another. Unfortunately, that's all anyone can do right now at this point is imagine because world peace will actually never take place. Now let's look at a smaller scale since world peace will never take place. Let's look at a smaller scale and let's consider family peace. Now, what if families who were at odds with one another made peace with one another? Or let's go to the neighbor. What if neighborly peace became important. And neighbors who were at odds with one another decided to make peace with one another. Fortunately, some families will make peace with one another, and some neighbors will make peace with one another. But the expectation for everyone to make peace with one another is in a world far, far away from Earth. The name of that land is, I believe, called Utopia. The peace that the world believes in is a life that is totally trouble-free. And when trouble does come, the answer is to take street drugs or to drink alcohol to solve the problem that will give you peace. If we need any help with peace from outside of ourselves, worldly wisdom says it will come in the form of possibly a spirit guide, or perhaps use some crystals or herbs, or meditate, which can actually be helpful. Or you can depend on money to bring you peace. The bottom line is the world says you are the source of your peace. Because Jesus is called the Prince of Peace, which is found in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, he also gives peace to those God favors or to those God is pleased with. The peace Jesus brings to earth is different from the world because it comes from the Holy Spirit, who lives within all believers. The Spirit changes them so that they can gain a measure of inner peace. When believers feel turmoil inside, they have the Holy Spirit as their resource. The Word of God tells us, be anxious for nothing, but in everything through prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God, and the peace, again, I say, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Likewise, as believers are changed into a more loving, more Christ-like people, they have the resources to better live at peace with those who are around them. We call these Christians. I like to call them disciples. The disciples or Christians develop the capacity to forgive wrongs done to them and be more aware of wrongs that they might do to others. As Christians or disciples increase in spiritual maturity, he or she will be able to help others in a way that would not have been possible before. As he or she differs to others in humility, many interpersonal conflicts are avoided. If it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone, found in Romans chapter 12, verse 18. In this way, the Christian experiences more internal peace. But what about the peace on earth that the angels proclaimed at Jesus' birth? Jesus' first coming did not bring international peace or world peace. However, he promised he would come again. The only way there will ever be world peace is when every knee bows and when every tongue confesses that Jesus is the Lord. And the Lord assumes his right place as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. When Christ reigns supreme and the nations are living in obedience to him, then there will be world peace. And the wolf shall dwell with the lamb. The leopard shall lie down with the goat, and the calf and the lion and the fatted calf together, and a little child will lead them. Amen. Let us pray. Dear God, I thank you for this word that was preached today. Dear God, I thank you in advance for the word that has touched hearts, minds, and souls. Father God, I thank you for Jesus, the one who we call the Prince of Peace, Wonderful Counselor. Allow us, Lord, to continue to experience the peace of Jesus, the peace of God in our lives as we interact with one another, family, friends, and co-workers. Allow them to see the light of Jesus in us. Help us, Lord God, in this Advent season leading up to the birth of the Savior of the world. Help us, Lord God, to be givers instead of receivers. Help us, Lord God, tell someone about the Savior of the Lord. Allow us, Lord God, to experience your peace each and every day. And we will forever give thy name the praise. In Jesus' name we pray together when we say amen.
Be blessed.
Thank you for joining us today. You can connect in the following ways: our Sunday morning worship at 11 a.m. via Facebook at Mount Olive, Waterbury, Connecticut, or our YouTube channel at Mount Olive AME Zion Church, or our website, MountOliveAMEZ.org. Or you can simply use the dial-in number, 339-207-6251. If you desire to make a donation, simply go to our website, or you can download the Giblify app and search for Mount Olive AME Zion Church. Again, thank you for tuning in. Hope we connect again.